Hello friends, and in this video I'll be helping you with the difference between delegation and decentralization. So let's start. So talking about the delegation, the meaning of it means handling over an authority from one person of high level to person of low level. So it is like transfer of authority from higher level person to a lower level person. But if we talk about the decentralization, it is the final outcome achieved when delegation of authority is performed systematically and repeatedly to the lowest level. So it is a kind of a outcome, or we can say what actually happens when we perform delegation of authority at a regular basis and in a systematic way. Okay, next is, if you talk about the delegation, it is a technique of management that needs to be used or that needs to be applied. But if we talk about the decentralization, it is a kind of a philosophy of management that needs to be understood. Okay, next is delegation is, in this what happens is superiors are responsible for acts done by subordinates. So the accountability is towards the superior. But if we talk about the decentralization, over here accountability is towards the department head. That is the, you can say, the top level persons. Okay, next is, if we talk about the delegation, is there any requirement? Is delegation required always? If we talk about it, then yes, for all organization, delegation of authority is necessary for executing of work. But if we talk about the requirement, whether decentralization is required, then no, as it is an optimal philosophy. It is a philosophy, right, which may or may not be adopted by organization. So it depends on organization whether they want to apply this philosophy or not. It's not necessary. Okay, next is, if we talk about the delegation, the ultimate control is in the hands of the superior. Okay, the superior has the main control over the subordinate staff for the work. But if we talk about the decentralization, over here the control is vested with the top management, or you can say the department heads that are responsible or that has the ultimate authority or control. Next is, if we talk about the delegation, it creates the superior subordinate relationship within an organization, whereas if we talk about the decentralization, it steps towards the creation of semi-autonomous units. Okay, so this was all about the difference between delegation and decentralization. So if you like the video, do hit the like button, do subscribing, and thanks for watching.